Namaste yogis and welcome to the channel. My name is Sean and today we'll be practicing yin yoga with the intention of releasing the full body. So we'll be targeting areas including our toes, moving up we'll be doing our quads, our hamstrings, abductors and adductors, so the four quadrants of the thigh. We'll also be doing our back, shoulder blades and shoulders, and even our neck as well. So taking a really holistic and balanced approach for today's yin yoga practice by targeting all these areas. You'll also be needing a bolster for today's practice as well, potentially a block, depending on your hip flexibility, as we will be doing half saddle as well. So to begin today's practice, I'll invite you to put your right arm into the air, and then placing your hand onto your left ear and bringing your right ear to your right shoulder. Centering in to this present moment. Slowing ourselves down. Allowing the body to relax. This next 45 minutes, we're really going to dedicate to ourselves. No distractions. Cultivating our presence and experiencing the richness of life in the here and the now. Releasing the right hand, returning the neck to center. I'm going to shift to the other side. So left arm coming up to the air, taking the left ear to our shoulder. Maintaining our mindfulness in this present moment. Softening, relaxing with each and every breath. Slowly releasing the neck, returning it to center. Going to come onto all fours now and threading the needle. So taking our right arm is going to come underneath our left arm. Then with our forehead, placing it onto the mat. Feeling that stretch. Feeling that sensation arise within the shoulder and the shoulder blade. Feeling into the chest expanding with each inhalation and contracting with each exhalation. Allowing the mind to become more still, more present, more true. Very mindfully feeling into each and every movement, shifting ourselves to the other side. So left arm now is going to thread underneath, placing our weights onto our shoulder and our forehead. Allowing for that sensation to arise and softening it with each and every breath. The yin is a process.
of accepting the truth in this present moment. And it's in this present moment where the richness of life can only ever be experienced. Never the past, never the future, but only in the here and the now. Taking a deep breath in and a long breath out. With full intention, we're going to transition into one of two positions, either Sphinx, which is where we keep our hands or our arms shoulder width apart, pressing upwards, releasing the lower back. Or if you prefer a stronger pose, seal, which is where we press up with our arms, maintaining our back to be disengaged as well. Personally, I'm going to hold my position in seal. Allowing the back to soften. Allowing the mind to relax. Embracing the inner silence within, the beautiful stillness that lies within each and every one of us. Taking the hips back. We're going to take our bolster now, placing it parallel with the mat, entering into a half saddle. So you can also place a block here, or like so, if required. If you need a little bit more assistance, that is perfectly fine. So, bending our right knee, left leg is going to extend out, sitting on the edge of the bolster, and then just lying back very gently, very gracefully, taking as much time as you require to enter into this pose. Because we do hold our poses for a longer period of time, it's important that we take our time to set up and enter the pose correctly and safely. And also so that we don't fidget or move as we hold our pose. If you do feel the urge to fidget, it's probably a good indication that you've taken it too far. So just use a prop or so forth to readjust and take it a little bit easier. safely exiting out of the pose. And we're going to switch to the other side now. So taking our left knee now, left knee is going to bend. Right leg is going to extend outwards. Once again, very slowly, very mindfully, lying back onto the bolster, feeling that sensation, that beautiful sensation arise within the left hip flexor. And consciously softening that space with each inhalation and exhalation. Deep breath in and a long breath out. Gently rising our torso to the sky. Taking the bolster to the side. And we're going to enter into a caterpillar. So taking our legs, extending them parallel with the mat. And then very gently, we're going to fold forward. I like to keep my palms facing upwards to resist the urge of pulling. Yin is never about forcing our body into a shape but rather just letting our body take us where it needs to take us. And once feeling the stretch that feels right for us, closing down the eyes and committing to stillness. Pressing ourselves upwards, lying back onto the mat, on the right hand side of the mat, I should say. Entering into a banana pose. So arms are going to come overhead, taking our feet to the left corner of the mat, and taking our arms to the left corner as well. Keeping your right glute onto the mat, pressing downwards, and feeling into that stretch arising within the left hip region. Sometimes when practicing yin, our mind wanders off into the past or into the future. This is perfectly normal, as it's the natural habit pattern of the mind. If you ever catch it doing this, simply smile. Accept that the mind has wandered and bring it back to the present moment at the level of sensation of the body or sensation of the breath. Gracefully switching to the other side. So taking our body, placing it on the left-hand side of the mats now. Taking our feet, actually first taking our arms above our head, sorry. Placing our feet in the right corner of the mat. Arms to follow suit. And then keeping our left glute back onto the mat. Feeling into that side stretch arising within the left hip. mindfully releasing ourselves. Sitting up slowly and entering into a frog pose. So coming onto all fours and spreading our legs outwards, allowing for that stretch to arise within the inner groin region. For gravity to work its magic. Feeling into that beautiful stretch. Feeling into the fascial tissues releasing and relaxing. Returning the body back to center. And coming into a toe pose. Just a shorter toe pose before we enter into Shavasana. So placing our weight, sitting back onto our toes. Maintaining our mindfulness with each and every breath. At your own pace, entering into Shavasana, and as we lie here on our backs, reflecting and feeling on how the body feels now in comparison to the start of our practice. Transitioning from the top of the body all the way down to the toes. Keep continuing to cultivate our mind-body awareness. Setting an intention once we conclude this yin practice to bring this awareness into our daily life, taking our practice into our daily life. Coming onto our sides and sitting up at your own pace. And to conclude the practice, I'd love to invite you to join me in the chant of Om, only if you wish, of course. So placing our hands together, closing down our eyes, taking a deep breath in. And a long breath out. And a breath in for Om. Om. And raising our hands to the third eye space, where we have wholesome thoughts. To the lips, may we speak the truth. And to the heart, may we act with loving kindness. From my heart to yours, namaste. And thank you so much for joining me in on today's full body yin yoga class in 45 minutes. It was a little bit of a challenge squeezing everything in, but we got there. If you have anything that you would like to share about your experience with today, feel free to drop a comment below. I always love hearing your guys' feedback. As well, if you made it this far and if you haven't subscribed to the channel already, I would appreciate your support. Currently trying to reach 1,000 subscribers so I can turn ads off during class. And lastly, just before you go, just wanted to wish you an amazing day, sending you my blessings and namaste.